I'm Stacey Flygirl Wilson.
I'm Melody Forrester.
And we're Creative Connectors. I'm an artist, a graphic designer, an event producer, and a teacher.
And I'm an attorney.
The mission of Creative Connectors is for Melody and I to connect the dots for creatives and give them opportunities that they may not have been able to get on their own, whether it be through creative services, legal services, workshops, on-site learning, just whatever we can offer.
One of the things that makes sense about Stacey and I working together is that between the two of us, we're probably one degree of separation of almost every artist in the city.
Yeah. And we met through DJ Jazzy Jeff, that's for sure.
I mean, we cover like a wide range of artists, and so sometimes all an artist needs is a phone number. They need an introduction. So, you know, we're able to do that, and there's a lot of currency in that, in being the connector to a resource. I represent Digable Planets. I co-manage the group along with two other people. And so we brought Digable here to Philadelphia. They performed a live concert at the Ardmore Music Hall. And we decided to do a live album. Then we needed artwork done. And Stacey and I, we do a lot of that work. Stacey designs most of my album covers for my artists and things like that. We did a lot of that work. So a photographer, Derek Brad, actually took the photos. And then Stacey transformed it into full album artwork.
What's up, Philly?
The great thing about artists, they're gonna do it regardless. They can't help it, they have to do it. But you know, when you're an independent artist, it involves so much more than the creating. These artists are multitaskers at the highest level. You're a creative, you're a bill collector, you're negotiating your own rates, you're making calls. It's just, there are not enough hours in the day. If I think about what I do for artists, it's just making their lives easier.
We also feature some merchandise. So these are some of the t-shirts that we feature.
If you're a creative and it's not a hobby and you're doing it for a living, it's like anything else. You have to handle the business parts or else you're not going to be able to survive on it. I think if I could point to one thing that artists struggle with, it's how to monetize their art and make it commercially viable.
It's branding, it's keeping things in people's hands, it's allowing them to wear your art as opposed to just hanging it on their wall. It's also advertising for you.
Because the music business has changed so drastically. Artists make less and less money from selling records. And I think, you know, I like to think of it as, you know, we not only sell music, but, you know, we have to be interested in the things that music sells.
It's also been a great experience throughout the whole pier. You know, I also produce events. We've done the Kids Sip and Paint, which we do every first Sunday of the month, which is amazing. We lead kids through a painting from beginning to end. We have kids from 3 years old to about like probably like 13, 14.
Yeah.
So no matter their level of skill, it's like we go through a painting that is pretty significant. They're by no means baby paintings.
Some pretty serious artwork comes out of it. Like some
yeah.
of the kids find out that they're good at something they didn't know, and the parents are surprised by it too.
Yes.
Yep. And they're very
yeah.
proud of their work.
Yes, they
and
are.
They're very
yeah.
proud of it. So, yep, it's always a good day. It's a lot of fun. It's great working with Stacey. You know, you have to have a good sense of humor to do this for a living. You really do. You have to have an appetite for risk and be a gunslinger and, you know, do a lot of things. I think trust is probably the most important part. I think that's the scary part for any business relationship, you know, because it all looks good on paper. But we have worked together long enough where we know we can count on each other.